I've been having a presentation today, and then I thought, just given this forum and the audience, that perhaps it's better that I have a talk. And what I'm planning to do is speak a little bit about Nalli as a business family and as a business, because I think we all know of it as the brand, but some of you may not be aware of how it started and the idea behind it, and we all know it. And then we move to my journey, and I'll talk a little bit about how I entered the family business 13 years ago, and what my journey has been like, and perhaps there would be things in there which is insightful and that could resonate with some of you out here. And we'll end with the lessons that I've learned and perhaps some musings that I have given today's current scenario. So we'll kick that off, and then if I'm going a little over time, I think any of you just let me know and then I'll come to So everyone is aware of, I think Nalli is, it's a sari brand, and we've got 35 stores, it's 700 crores. It's 100% privately held, privately owned. So what that means is we've done all of this internally through our own generation of funds. There hasn't been any external investors or anything promoting that. The other thing unique about the business is that I am now the fifth generation. Typically there's a saying that says shirt sleeves to shirt sleeves in three generations. What that means is the first generation builds it, the second generation somewhat manages it. By the time the third generation comes in, they almost destroy the business. So clearly something has worked with us where we've endured for so long and we continue to hold true to the core values that we started out with. If I go right back to the beginning and the origin of it, so there's three phases that I can pick up in the history of the company. There were the early years, which was pre-1940s. The formative years, which was between the 40s and the 70s. And then the growth years, which was 1980s, 90s and onwards till about now. Now the early years, a lot of people think the company was, the company came into existence in 1928, and that's true. But we were always a community of weavers. So my family comes from the Padmasali community, which is a vegan community. There's very few of us in the world, most of us in Andhra, and there was a drought around the 1880s, which was when a group branched off and then moved to Kumbakonam and Kanjuram and that went, and they had settled. And that's the group that you see now who form the Kanjuram weavers, and they set up there, and they were originally from Andhra, and they moved out due to drought.